But imagine, for example, that your desire is to build a little model railway. You know, little trains running on little tracks alongside little houses. Obviously, you have a very small budget, so maybe your railway won't be with little houses or any other pleasant decorations, actually. You also don't have that much space at your home, so most likely the track layout won't be very interesting, but it can be done. Except, it can't be done, because you as an individual probably suck. You know, a model railway takes a lot of work to put together, and in all likelihood, you are unable to motivate yourself. So really, there's likely no way that you could build a model railway. The same thing is true for other things as well. If you want a slightly masculine example, because I know a lot of people in our society are very masculine, you can also think of fireworks. Obviously, fireworks are also very expensive. If you have a particular desire for lighting fireworks, the actual works in question will likely be very limited. Without a doubt, I can assure you that your fireworks will not look like some of the fireworks you may have seen on YouTube. That is really unfortunate. How can we solve this kind of problem? As a popular meme states, apes together strong. That is the answer. If we want to accomplish something great, we shouldn't do it on our own. If you want fireworks, it is better if you do it together. And if you want to build a model railroad, it would also be much better if you did not build it alone in your own home, but at the place of a friend with more space and with more friends or comrades, as you can call them in this context. Not only for economical reasons, but also because it would literally be more fun that way. But alas, I obviously no longer go to school, so there's no way anymore to make new friends. Everybody my age already has accumulated far too many friends to be able to make new friends anymore, so that is not possible, unfortunately. But it is strange though that something so obvious as apes together strong is actually something that is almost never put into practice. In our society, a thing like a model railroad would always be owned privately. And a similar thing continues to be true for fireworks. And this might indicate that there is a problem in our society. In some sense, maybe we are addicted to having individual possessions. Books, for example, are always owned privately, even though that's not very practical in actuality. A lot of people own 100 or so books that they themselves only read a small handful of times. You know, they bought those books rather than going to the library for them. I literally do not know why this is. In extreme cases even, an individual might even buy 2 copies of a book, one to put on the shelf untouched and one that they actually intend to use. Imagine wasting resources for literally no reason. On a personal level, communism really always makes more sense, but it seems that people always choose capitalism, with inferior fireworks and inferior model railroads as a result.